She's looking for a ball. I guess I had a ball. Usually I had a ball on my head. Sick.
I can't even. Does him. Well, Sharon, now this is candid camera. What do you think of it?
Oh, wonderful.
Mm-hmm. Yes, I am.
Action shot.
Cool. All right, we're going to go for a walk.
Man, I recognize you after a couple of years, you know.
Well, I think she is a bit of an engineer.
Yeah. Look at all
several things. Yeah.
Everything.
I understand.
Yeah.
I'll start praying about that sea and
I think that's cool.
I think the only thing that makes the booth tonight is supporting Patty. I think this would be a big thrill for her to be there and have all her friends and family to come out. And she's giving a talk on Thursday at 1 o'clock. If any of you can come back for that, we'd also for the wonderful artwork that she has. So it's a really fine way for us to share the success of our students. And so we're thrilled to have Patty's work in the show. And it's lovely, and it's been a very well-received show. We've just had so many people. I want to thank both artists for the terrific job that they've done. And it's an exciting show, and it's really... that has come back to us in many different ways. So thanks very much, and I know Patty has some more to say. So
thank you, Shelley, for letting me have a show. And the reason why I have this show is because I did get this grant. The grant, I had to show them slides and document that I had some art. And it was for building these shadow boxes, which if you met Sherry, I hope you did. She was Sherry at New Frame, and she did all the boxes, shadow boxes, and it was fairly difficult. And there's Joe out in the hall, my baby. He and I built made the molding. They're alder molding, and it just greatly simplifies and reduces the cost of frame building for shadow boxes. If you have a molding that you can just build a box of glass and then slip the artwork in the back. I didn't bring an example, but you probably can see. I mean, general ideas. I put the frames together for about $25 a piece, and they would be $50 for the small one, $200 to $500 for the large one. So I really wouldn't have the cost or the ability to have a show with this type of work if I didn't receive the grant. So I was really happy about getting the grant. So chronologically, I'll just start chronologically, and the Morning Mountains series began as a, like both series have a connection. I often write greeting cards to people. Sometimes they don't get to the person that I'm writing them to. I want to make somebody a special card, and it becomes like a thumbnail sketch for something else. I go, oh, I like this, and then I turn it into a piece of art later on. And this was, these were Christmas cards 1 year. I can just pass it around. And that was for the Morning Mountains. I went through the graphic design program here at Lynn Benton and graduated in 1989. John Aikman's and Jim Tolbert's graphics were first wine bottles, and then they were Morning Mountains, basically. And when I finished school at OSU in 90, my mother does stained glass. I conned her and my sister-in-law into making some of the putting all the stained glass together. I didn't want to learn another project, so I they did the stained glass. And the whole concept for me with Morning Mountains is creating a feeling, an impression of the mountains that I see here in the Willamette Valley in the east and in the west. Not to duplicate what I see, but to give a feeling by going just with the color. And I find it's really important for my own self that God is the best artist, and we have cameras for that. And what I do is just an impression of a feeling. And I'm not trying to copy nature, but to just give a feeling of what is here. And they're all embossed. I create an embossing board, and then I do watercolors, prismacolors. Sometimes add stitching. If I don't like something, I tear it off, cut it, add something. Sharon Summer was like that because she was at my house when I started it, and it's what happened is I made a big mistake and I just cut it off and started over, and it works. As a graphic designer, there's an awful lot of tension involved in getting things perfect, and when my fine art, I just let it happen. I enjoy it and take each piece for what it is. I'll have a concept, and if it doesn't turn out exactly like that concept, I go with it. It's somebody once said, each piece has its own birth, you know, Rodin doesn't know what the rock is, it becomes itself. I try not to put my art in little boundaries and feel upset if it doesn't turn out exactly like my first concept was, because just personally, when I close my eyes, I see images, or I see something, two colors, and that's where I start, and that's where most everything comes from. Claude Monet worked in plein air, and he tried to, do you remember his haystacks? He, over and over again, he painted these haystacks, and at certain times of days, attempting to capture the colors. I'm doing this from memory and from photographs, because at this time in my life, I can't get out the baby and near a highway and paint, but I appreciate and respect what the masters have done, and try to remember to keep trying until you get something right, you know, exhaust an idea or a subject until it's, and then you can go on to something else. I hope I live long enough, because I have so many subjects I'd like to cover. And that's about it. Like I said, I really appreciate my mother's help doing, and my sister-in-law's help, Penny, who's not here, the other sister, Penny, that's Debbie back there. She did some stained glass and lines, my mommy right there. And so I just am hoping that I captured a feeling of Oregon and the Willamette Valley and those pieces. And they're horizontal because they're horizons, and that, you know, that's just when I think of a landscape, it's horizontal. And then the Writing Letters series is the next series, and they're all vertical except for one piece, which was a mistake in framing at a Beards filled a frame wrong. And I had to create a whole piece. It's called Connie's Letters, that piece back there. And then the Four Falls, because my mind just worked in a different way horizontally, and I had to come up with that. And I kept promising Connie that piece, which was actually supposed to be this one right here. So that's how that came about. Anyway, again, they were letters that I was writing, and they began as a thumbnail sketch in experimental drawing school at experimental drawing at Clint Brown's class, and he basically let me do whatever I wanted. And I loved that. This is pretty gruesome. I call it a voodoo drawing. I was drawing somebody I didn't like, and I was making it kind of gross, and I decided to go away from that. I was writing a letter to my friend, and I was making him a card. This is my own fishing partner, Charlie. He lives in Portland now. And I never sent him the letter. I sent him a postcard and told him I had a breakthrough. I was going to make beautiful art, things that people enjoy. I feel like with a real, like with a portrait or a landscape, you're trapped with that. You look at it over and over and over again. You might see something new, but I don't know, with an abstract piece, you're not trapped. You can look at it and see something new, and just, it fits in with your moods, I'm hoping. So there's Charlie's letter, and Mr. and Mrs. Tolbert purchased that piece. I was very excited about that. And it's the thing that started the whole rest of the series. Plus, I made cards for my husband when we first met and fell in love. I was often writing him love notes, and that's an actual letter to pick right down here, and it became the Another Friday and Love Letters Friday, because this whole series was created like the installation in my mind to get me going. I didn't really have a concept that had to be hung that way, but it was 3 rows of 7 for a total of 21, and it started out with Mondays, which were kind of lavender, you know, Monday, you know, it's not very passionate, it's Monday, it's silver and gray, and then it, Fridays starts getting, the colors start getting warmer and more passionate, because you're looking, everybody likes Friday, and that's why these Friday love letters are like actual prototypes of letters that I wrote to Vic. I mean, the beginnings were like that. Or if Vic would wear a jersey, blue and gold, that's the pieces in here. That's how that happened. And everything's mixed medium. I take away, I add, I subtract, I sew, I glue, I try to use archival things like sewing and non-acidic tape and 100% cotton papers, and so that they'll last and they'll stick together so that in the shadow boxes they won't fall apart. And I'm hoping I can go on and create more of both, if I can generate some cells, because I can't rationalize doing any more until I do that. And with the baby, I have to hire a babysitter to have time to work, and if I'm not earning any money, I won't be. It's silly to hire someone and pay somebody when you're not making any money, but I'm going to work no matter what, even if it drives me crazy. The house gets messy and things. I really have many plans for the future. That's just about it, and I thank everybody for coming and putting up with me and my moods and my frenzies. And any questions?
Having on one of the letters, how much time do you have involved from conception through the time you have it finished?
Well, actually a lot of time. Anywhere from 10 to 20 to 30 hours. It just really meant to say I would start something and I might not like it. So I just let it, I would work in groups. Like I have an easel with cork board, and I put two up on there, put some up on the wall, have some on the drawing table. So there's four or five in the studio at once. And so it really depends. Some things go quickly, other things don't. And I forgot to mention that the shadow boxes are usually called balings because of the whale baling and how the whale filters. I was very inspired by a whale watching class that my mother and I took. I can't remember, it must have been winter term, right? When the whales are running. And I've always had that tendency to tear paper and do things with it. So then. That answer your questions?
Thank you.
Thank you. Well, let's eat cookies. Thank you, everybody, for coming.
Thank you for being here.
Thank you.